Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Trendonomics by Hurst. What a day it was. We almost went to 14,350, filled the gap, and almost 400 plus recovery and a bullish close. So what next? Are the bulls back? I'm going to talk about Nifty Bank Nifty, a couple of stocks. This is going to be an interesting video. Watch till end. Upstock is currently giving a free demat account, and you can study option chain, option charts, option strategies, and backtest and modification. So definitely interesting. And they are offering 6% interest if you open it along with IndusInd Bank. So if you wish to open, you can open it from the link in description. If you are new to this channel, if you still haven't subscribed, subscribe, share, like, comment, follow me on Twitter. This is my Twitter handle, @Thursday684, where I discuss live market updates. If you should learn Elliott Wave, we still have a discounted price or webinar on Elliott Waves, where I've discussed all the patterns, the motive waves, corrective waves, how to trade opportunities in different asset classes, how to spot highest probability trading opportunities, identifying major turning points, riding big waves, boost your confidence, improve trading using combination of tools like RSI, Fibonacci, moving averages, trend line, trend channels, and combining the price action, momentum, and wave principle. The common mistake people do and how to avoid them. I'm also giving this free ebook by Frost and Practo and a lot of other resources. So just register from the blog Trendonomics or from the pinned tweet on my Twitter profile or from the link in description. And I'm giving you this free ebook even if you don't register. So just grab it from link in description. Let's discuss the market. So almost 400 plus recovery from the bottom of 14,350. We filled this gap. Yes, we almost nearly filled this gap. And our minimum downside target has been achieved. I posted a chart on Twitter, my Twitter handle, in the morning. This was that chart. I said Nifty achieved wave equality and trend channel and the gap support. So definitely it was a message from market. Maybe we will have some recovery. Yes, definitely I did not expect a recovery of 400 plus points, but I saw that my target almost achieved and there is a chance of pullback. So we covered most of our short positions, and definitely I posted on Twitter so that the followers, my followers, should gain from this. I hope you gained it. Those who were holding short might have covered after watching this chart. Hope so. Are we bottomed out? Is it the possible bottom and we go higher from here? With just one candlestick, I cannot really say whether we have bottomed out and we should be going higher. But certainly, I cannot rule out that possibility. Why? Definitely, I will discuss that. A lot of things. First and foremost things, we have almost closed this gap and we have achieved the target. We have achieved the target of equality as per the wave principle. And so when I say equality, that means first leg where we said it's maybe WXY or ABC. Now definitely after this recovery, I cannot call this an ABC. This more looks like WXY. So this fall was around from 15,430 to 14,470. So around 900 points. And again, we have got 900 plus point fall from this high. So it has achieved the equality, price equality. It has closed this gap. And again, it tested this trend channel. So our minimum downside target has been met. And definitely, when your target is done, you have to book your positions. Either you book or you trail. Since it was almost oversold on hourly with the positive divergence, I decided to book most of my positions. I booked some of the positions a little later. Yes, we entered short, but we exited again With a stop loss, yes, definitely. I entered short on this pullback over here near 14,600. And then when market again went above this swing high, I covered my short positions because definitely it's no point of holding a losing position, right? So on a pullback, I thought maybe we have done the pullback and we should be going down. So I entered the short here, but after I saw that it's not going down, so we exited here. Yes, definitely at end of the day, I have again entered short positions, but not very huge short position, and I have entered through puts rather than future. But I don't have highly bearish bias as of now. I'm still considering the possibility of a bottom here. Yes, I'm considering we might have actually formed a bottom out here. Why? Because we have already achieved the targets, downside targets. Most of the time, bottoms are always, 90% of the time, bottoms are formed on Friday, today being Friday. And we got a very huge recovery and almost a bullish candle. Yes, we can say piercing candle or whatever. So all the possibilities of bottom are here. So why cannot it be a bottom? Definitely, it could be a bottom. But yes, we need some more confirmation. So I'm not highly bullish here, but definitely I'm not highly bearish. So I'm neutral. Despite I have a position, that's different view, point. I took the chance. I merely took the chance because this rally is just a three-wave rally, and this could be another X wave, maybe WXY. And if we break below 14,600 or maybe 14,560, then we resume the downtrend and we go down. Basically below this trend line, basically below this breakout point near 14,600 odd. So if we break it, we have a chance that, okay, the downtrend again resume. I have again a lot of things because of which I entered the short position again, but I'm not taking the risk via future. I just entered the puts because I don't want to lose the profits made here, definitely. And because I'm not much, very much sure or not much highly bearish. So definitely, if we get a five-wave rally, this is still a three-wave rally. So if we start getting supports near 14,650, and then we start going higher again. And if we get a five-wave rally, then definitely I will say that maybe we have bottomed out and we should be going higher. So in that case, definitely I will say we are going to new highs if we get a five-wave rally. Not until then. Until then, I don't know where it's going. Honestly, I don't know where it's going because with just one candlestick, I cannot really say whether it will go up or it will go down. Yeah, but if we break below 14,560 to 14,560, then definitely I will say, you know, we have downside pending and we should be going down towards maybe another test of this channel, maybe 14,200, 14,100, but not before we break 14,600 or 14,560. Unless and until we break that, I will definitely not. I will definitely avoid saying that we are going to go down, or rather, I will not suggest that one should carry very huge short positions. Because definitely, it's no point going or trading against the trend. If market wants to go up, then there is no point in going short. So, yes, at this point of moment, I will definitely won't suggest aggressive shorts. And again, no aggressive longs. Wait, watch what market is doing, and then decide what you want to do, which trade you want to do. So definitely, if we hold above this trend channel, above 14,650, 670, then I will say, okay, maybe we have bottomed out and we should be going higher. If we break below 14,560, then I will say we should be going down. Till then, no bias. Bank Nifty again. Yes, Bank Nifty definitely is still below this resistance zone, and it looked like a descending triangle breakdown and we should be going down. But we have tested this gap. I said that maybe 33,100, 33,300 could be one of the targets, the minimum target. So again, minimum target on Bank Nifty has been done. But unless and until we get a five-wave rally, I won't be sure whether the correction is over in Bank Nifty. So again, wait and watch for a clear bullish signal in Bank Nifty, Nifty. Till then, no bias. Because a couple of stocks, we discussed SBI, which again, it's coming off, it's filled this gap, and on daily chart, it's taking support of 34-day moving average. I said maybe we might go down towards 320-30 because of this head and shoulders formation. But yes, we have a hammer candlestick today and a good volume. So is the correction over? Again, I don't know. But the minimum target of 355 has been done on SBI. Again, Reliance. It's a huge bullish candle today. But there is no pattern. Currently, I cannot say whether it will go up or down. Because there is no pattern, recognizable pattern here in terms of price action also, in terms of elliott wave also. I'm not sure whether the correction is over, whether are we going down again. But yes, definitely, if Reliance goes above today's high 2100 and the resistance of 2120, if we close above it, then definitely with the wattage of 10% in Nifty, definitely Reliance can drag Nifty higher. Unless if we again break below 2000 levels, then definitely we will go down. So again, no bias over here, but being a heavyweight stock, definitely we would like to watch the price action in Reliance. If we break and close about 2100 to 2120, then we might be going up. One stock our subscriber requested, HDFC Life, so I'm discussing it. So again, it is breakdown from this trend line, trend channel, and possibly if we break this support as well, then we might see some downward pressure. But until then, wait and watch. If we break and close again above this, then we might go up. But currently, uptrend has been violated in this stock. So avoid buying this stock. Definitely, I won't suggest a long unless and until it again get back into uptrend. The major worry for equity is dollar, definitely the dollar. So the reason I initiated short again was more because of dollar rather than Nifty. Dollar is again resuming the uptrend. So at end of the day, 330 or 320, dollar index was trying to break out of this, had already broken out of this trend channel, downward trend channel, and coming back in uptrend. So definitely, if dollar is going higher, if dollar index is going higher, dollar is going to strengthen, then definitely it will put pressure on equities. So that's why I'm not very sure about correction getting over. I'm also not very highly bearish as of today's close, yes, definitely. If we again break and close below 14,560, I will turn bearish again and say maybe we are going to 14,100 or maybe 14,000, but not until then. But yes, definitely the worry is dollar. Dollar is definitely could be a threat to equity, because if it is going higher to the level of 94, ideally, we talked yesterday also, if it's going above this level, above this trend line, above this swing high of 92, then we should be going higher to 94 odd, which is this swing high. And we said that this is double bottom breakout, and again, it is taking support and resuming uptrend. So this is worry. A dollar is one reason I took shots again in Nifty. Definitely, a three-wave rally was another reason. And one more reason is, was in Nifty. Almost we had a very huge pullback. And we almost tested near the resistance zone. 14,750 is a resistance zone. So definitely, it will definitely act as a resistance unless until it is taken out. That's why I shorted, and the risk is low now, definitely. If we have very high pullback, then there is a chance that market gives up and comes down. So low risk point entry, it was definitely risk was low. And this was still a three-wave pullback. And the dollar, definitely the dollar was the reason. Dow Jones, again, I would say Dow Jones is another thing to worry about, because Dow is trying to come down again from the highs. So again, if there is a sell-off in foreign markets, it could affect our market as well. So definitely dollar coming down from, sorry, Dow coming down after testing highs. And if Dow gives a trend reversal, downtrend reversal, then definitely it will affect our market. So this is one more reason that, okay, maybe we might not be bottomed out yet, and we may again go down. So pressure from foreign markets, dollar, and a three-wave pullback rally are the main reasons. I'm still not confident about this being a bottom. But definitely, after looking at this candle, I cannot remain highly bearish, because my target has been met. Simply, my target has been met. Target of this gap fill has been met. And today being Friday, and there is high possibility of bottoming out on Friday. As per my observation, most of the time bottoms are formed out on Friday. So I cannot rule out the possibility of bottom. So at the end of the day, if you are feeling like confused, yes, definitely. If you don't have very strong opinion, I'm the kind of person, I say, okay, I don't know, I'm not sure. If I'm not sure, why should I say that market will go up or market will come down? I will wait and watch. Yes, so wait and watch. So I have given you the levels. Definitely, it's no point looking at upside resistance. I can give you the resistance. It is definitely 14,875. That's 14,870. That's the swing high, or that's the 13-day moving average resistance. But of course, it's no point in looking at resistance. Rather, I will look at the supports below which, that is definitely below 14,620. That's 34-day moving average. 50-day EMA, and maybe below 14,560, 14,500. I will say, okay, market will again resume the downtrend. But no bias as of today's close, no bias on either side, on upside or downside. I will review on Monday next week how the market behaves, and then decide whether are we bottomed out or we are going to go down again. So that's it from today's update. If you like this video, share with your friends. subscribe to this free YouTube channel, subscribe, share, like, comment, follow me on Twitter, and keep sharing and keep learning. This is us signing off. Until we meet again.